Breaking: Democratic Party about to implode after Obama admin just threw Clinton's under the bus in major way. The Democrat Party loves to portray themselves to the American public as a united front fighting for the disadvantaged and the so-called oppressed in the country. Though with just a little digging, that camaraderie facade falls apart like a cheap suit from Walmart. Ever since President Donald Trump trounced Hillary Clinton last year, the Democratic Party has been in shambles with no clear leadership, which has led to infighting in the already fractured party. With President Trump draining the swamp and closing in on the scoundrels in Washington, D.C., that have been actively destroying our country, top Democratic officials are turning on each other to save their skin. And that is precisely what just happened when advisors from Barack Obama's administration stepped forward to torpedo the Clinton clan, which could finish the already floundering Democratic Party for good. Over the past several weeks, there have been multiple sexual allegations made against politicians as well as top Hollywood executives that has rocked the establishment. Senator Al Franken, Harvey Weinstein, Kevin Spacey, and Charlie Sheen all have been fingered as sexual deviants, with many people calling for their arrest to answer for their crimes. However, while their nasty deeds are disgusting, they aren't the first liberal scum to use their power and status to prey on innocent victims. As we all are aware, Bill Clinton was known for his malfeasance while in office as governor and president of the United States. For years, Democrats have turned a blind eye to Bill Clinton's sexual assaults and rape allegations so that they could use his popularity to push their sick liberal agenda forward in the country. Barack Obama used Bill Clinton to help his campaign in 2012, and also Bill campaigned for two-timed failed presidential candidate and wife, Hillary Clinton. Well, now that cozy arrangement appears to be falling apart as former top advisors to both Barack Obama and even Bill Clinton are coming forward to support Monica Lewinsky. Following multiple sexual misconduct allegations made against high-profile politicians like Roy Moore and Al Franken, former top advisors to President Obama and the Clintons have voiced their support for Monica Lewinsky. During an interview with MSNBC, Jennifer Palmieri, the communications director for Hillary Clinton, who also worked for Bill Clinton's administration, said that she was sorry for everything Lewinsky had gone through. "Monica Lewinsky was my intern, and the relationship the president had with her was very inappropriate," she said. "It was a consensual relationship, but he was the president of the United States and she was a 24-year-old intern, that is taking advantage of a power dynamic on a historic scale." She also revealed that in April she ran into Lewinsky for the first time in 20 years, and "I told her that I was really sorry for everything that she had been through. Her whole life was defined by this one mistake, and her life was, I don't want to say it was ruined because I hope it's not," she added. Palmieri was also asked to respond to a comment that Senator Kirsten Gillibrand, DNY, made during an interview with the New York Times, in which she said she thought Bill should have stepped down from the presidency during the scandal. Gillibrand had previously endorsed Hillary during the 2016 election and entered the Senate in 2009 after she was elected into Hillary's former seat after she became Secretary of State under Obama. "The Clintons have done an enormous amount of good in this country, and despite that, they've got friends who are not always going to be there for them. And it's something I've seen happen to them quite a bit, but they'll survive," Palmieri said of Gillibrand's comments. Not only did Palmieri show public support for Monica Lewinsky, but so did Reverend Al Sharpton and former Obama staffer Alyssa Mastromonaco. Then, Senator Kirsten Gillibrand, a New York Democrat, also came forward this past Thursday stating that Bill Clinton should have resigned from office after his affair with Lewinsky was discovered. "This public support for Monica Lewinsky is a long time coming, especially from those in the Democratic Party that has made a living throttling males for so-called mansplaining and rape culture in America. The Clintons all but destroyed Monica for coming forward about her sexual encounters with Bill Clinton while he was president. Instead of the Hillary Clinton blaming her husband for using his power to seduce the young intern, Hillary unleashed a series of personal attacks against Lewinsky that ultimately destroyed any chance of her having a career. So, after decades of Democrats taking Bill Clinton's side, it is shocking to see these former advisors now saying the opposite of the past narrative. This change in the narrative proves that the Democratic Party is imploding on itself, and it is only a matter of time before it is further destroyed. Without any apparent leadership, the Democrats are in disarray and are now turning on themselves to save their own skin from more embarrassment by their own hypocrisy. What will happen next is anyone's guess, but hearing of top advisors throwing Bill Clinton under the bus for his sexual deviancy does serve as a good indication that the Liberal Party may be beyond repair. Drew Bear.